David, well, Mississippi's only PGA Tournament is just days away, and organizers say this year's event is do or die.
Yeah, the Tour Stop has a new name and new sponsors. 16 WAPT's Meg Pace is live from Annandale tonight. So, Meg, what's at stake this year?
Well, Stephanie, Darren, I can tell you it's a lot more than that trophy and check that one pro will win on this course. For Annandale, Madison, and the state of Mississippi, the entire classic is on the line. There's a new name, a new look.
Got our nice little fountain here to welcome everybody.
And new hope that the state's only PGA tournament will live on.
The tournament's good for Mississippi, good for Annandale, and bring a lot of cash in.
The True South Classic has had a lot of names.
Southern Farm, Power Guarantee, yes.
But to Shelby Merritt and John Hudson, it's the same tournament they've been working on for a combined 57 years.
A lot of tournaments. Lots of tournaments.
If we lose it, it'll be a devastation.
John Morovich is the new director, fighting to keep the pros returning to Annandale.
Shame to lose it. It would. I mean, you got one of 45 cities that, you know, hosts something like this. It's got a economic impact of more than $22 million.
Viking announced last year that 2011 would be its last as the name sponsor. With just months to go, the Century Club organization stepped in, using a reserve fund to support this year's event.
With the tight time frame that we had, you know, in announcing in April, a lot of companies had already set their budgets and things like that. So, you know, we've had a lot of new companies that are involved with the tournament.
Now organizers are pushing to get tens of thousands to the course to land another title sponsor that will ensure this event stays alive.
It's been around for 45 years, and we hope and are optimistic it'll continue for another 45.
Now, one of the biggest changes at this year's tournament is that organizers are going to let fans get right up and close to that winning putt on the 18th hole. They're actually going to let people stand around the hole within feet. But used to, you had to pay extra for tickets to get in the stands right there at the hole. And this year, they're going to let people get right there and close. Stephanie.
Well, Meg, I remember when it was called the Viking Classic, we had all of those cooking demonstrations. What about this year?
Well, the tournament director admits to me that they can't pull in the big names like Emeril Lagasse that Viking could. So what they've done is they've gone local. Fondren is going to be sending in some of their biggest chefs to do some cooking here at the tournament.
That'll work. All right, Meg Pace, thank you so much.